To better explain the concept of the double entry system, let us refer back to the accounting equation that we introduced in the third video of this series. Assets equals liabilities plus equity. And as we said before, the asset side shows what resources the business has, and the liability and equity side shows from where the business got these resources. There is a group of accounts under each one of these categories. If there is an increase in one of the asset accounts, then to maintain the balance of the equation, there should be a corresponding increase in one of the accounts on the other side of the equation, or an offsetting decrease in one of the accounts on the same side of the equation. In the previous video, Mr. Stick contributed cash of $100,000 to establish his business. The resource that the business got is the cash of $100,000, and that increase in cash is debited to the cash account, which is an asset account. That is the first part of the entry. The second part focuses on from where the business got that cash. It is the owner of the business who injected that cash to increase the capital of the business. So, there is an obligation to the owner of the business, and that obligation is recorded by increasing or crediting the capital account, which is an equity account, by $100,000. So the transaction was recorded in two accounts, and this is what we call the double entry bookkeeping. Assume that the business was granted a $50,000 loan from a bank. The resource that business got is the cash of $50,000, and that increase in cash is debited to the cash account, which is an asset account. The business got that cash from the bank as a loan, so there is an obligation to the bank for the amount of this loan, which should also be recorded, and therefore the loan account in the liability side is increased or credited by $50,000 to reflect that obligation. Also, this transaction was recorded in two accounts. Assume that the business bought a piece of land for $110,000 in cash. Here, the resource that the business got is the piece of land, and that is recorded by increasing or debiting the land account by $110,000. From where did the business get that piece of land? It is the business that paid for the land from its own cash. So, there is a decrease in cash, and that decrease is recorded by crediting the cash account by $110,000. So, any business transaction has a double effect, and therefore, recording any transaction involves at least two accounts. This is what we call the double entry bookkeeping.